I'm the go with the flow type person, day by day type person, and everything.
And you put your grind in. Your first EP came out when?
Yeah, my first. Wow, I'm 2012. Where's Justin at? I don't know where he is.
Yeah,
but my manager Justin Lamont has been with me since 2012, and he encouraged me to drop this EP. I was feeling depressed, didn't even want to drop it anymore. I was just feeling weird about like the industry.
Right. It can do that.
Yeah, I dropped my EP Ariography, which that's how Omen found out about my music, right. Who put me on.
Then
the
you
Cole.
Did the collaboration with Omen.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then what was it? Like maybe a year later?
Three.
Couple years later?
Yeah, it's been years, like years.
Mm-hmm. Then you actually get something dropped on Dreamville.
Mm-hmm. Because I started dropping stuff on SoundCloud, because I decided I was going to, like, upgrade my sound, you know, make it a little bit more ratchet, because I was, like, this sweet, angelic, neo-soul girl, but then I was like, I'm lying to myself, I'm not that sweet or angelic, so I had to get a little ratchet, and I teamed up with DJ Grumble, dropped some ratchet tunes, Backseat, Goat, Yingling with Felly on SoundCloud. And then, Cole was impressed by, like, that stuff. He hadn't heard. He didn't get the chance to
hear. He didn't
really
get a chance to hear the previous stuff?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But they just heard, like, that stuff that was really moving on SoundCloud. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, they believed when they saw that.
And so then when that happened for you, you said that earlier on you felt weird about the music industry. Because it can be a turnoff.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and you do kind of have to have a thick skin and kind of like tunnel vision.
Oh, yeah.
You know?
Oh, yeah.
So at that point, when you actually really, you saw something of yourself, you saw your work released on Dreamville, like, was it real for you? Realest it's ever been for you at that point, as far as telling you, yes, this is what I'm supposed to be doing. I'm not going to, you know, bow down from the weirdness that is in this industry sometimes. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
How did you feel? Did it give you some gusto?
No. I didn't feel like I was good vocally live then. I felt like there was so much work to do. I mean, my voice wasn't trained, so I was hoarse a lot. This, like, there was notes in Backseat that I was even afraid to attempt live. And now, naturally, it's so easy to do those songs. But for some reason, in the beginning, it was really hard.
Mm-hmm.
And so anybody out there who wants to sing and they feel like their voice sucks live, you can actually work and it could get better. Like, I think constant touring and opening up for Cole and Drum and Party Next Door and Black, it changed my whole life. Like, my voice got stronger.
Which brings us all the way to this new single.
Yeah.
And the title of the new single is?
Break Me Off.
And what is Break Me Off about?
Break Me Off is about getting broken off by the one you love.
See, I needed to hear her say that.
Okay. All right. Just a little bit of breaking. Okay.
But you found do you feel like you found your character in what you're doing? You found your niche.
Now,
you're comfortable in your slot now.
Yes. Now I'm beyond comfortable. And I really think it's because of just time. Like, and also putting in that work and dropping in two projects that I believe in my heart is me and solid. Like, Foe is solid. You know what I'm saying? And Shea Butter Baby to me is solid, like, in my soul. Like, it's my baby. So, yeah, I feel good now. I feel confident in where
I'm
at.
Well, I'm happy
now.
You do, because I had all the confidence in the world in you. From the minute my daughter played me your music, I was like, okay.
Thank you.
I get it.
Thank you.
Where this one's going.
Wow.
Yeah. So what do you look forward to now? Now that you're at this stage in your career, what do you look forward to moving forward?
I just look forward to my dream loft and a fenced-in backyard for my dog Galactus. That's most important.
See? Priorities, okay. Ladies and gentlemen.
All right. And I don't know, some type of creek in the backyard. Just a lovely, like, forest in my backyard for my nephew and my dog.
This all sounds like perfect setting as far as muse to write more incredible songs.
Exactly.
That's what it sounds like to me.
That's what I look forward to.
Okay, so Ari has officially adopted herself another auntie.
Yes, thank you. I need you.
Her name is Monie, and I am at your beckon and call, my sweet.
Wow.
I'm really proud of your journey
so
far.
You're legendary.
And honey, Just remember to invite your legendary cracking knees auntie to the backyard
your knees
barbecue.
Aren't cracking.
Okay, my knees got more cracked than Harlem
girl,
in the 80s, girl.
Please.
Stop playing.
No, okay. No. Oh my God.
But really, I'm really proud of your journey.
Thank you.
I can't wait to take a picture with you and show off to
yes,
my daughter because she,
same.
She's
to
one
show
of your
you
she's one of your hugest fans. Charlena, I'm talking to your
Hi,
girl.
Charlena, honey. Thank you for putting me on to your amazing, beautiful, and amazingly talented mom. Thank you
for putting me on to this yes, young lady that I'm so looking forward to seeing Grammy performance by you because that's mm-hmm, coming. Mm-hmm. I'm so
wow,
looking for yeah,
I pray.
Yeah, it is. I've just put it out into the cosmos.
Wow, okay? I pray.
So that's happening.
Wow.
Also, what's happening is I'm going to see you at BET yeah, the weekend.
Oh, I would love that.
I'm going to see you at Essence Fest.
I would love it all.
I'm going to see you. I'm putting all of these things
thank
out into
you,
the cosmos.
Thank you. Hey,
okay?
Y'all, BET, Essence, please.
All of that. Okay. And I wish you the most success in
thank
your career.
You.
Again, let everybody know the name of the single, where they can find it.
Yes.
And your social platforms also, if you have any.
So yeah, y'all could check out my newest single, Break Me Off, on all platforms, as well as Shea Butter Baby. And yeah, I'm on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Farmers Only, Christian Mingle, Tinder, Bumble.
I did, but no.
I'm just kidding.
I did, and I'm not kidding. And I
oh,
was on
did?
It. I was on it for a hot 2 days.
Me too.
And then
I was
really gone.
Did do Bumble.
I did
last
too.
Fall, just
you
should have
seen me.
Second.
I was like swipe, swipe, swipe,
okay,
swipe, 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 swipe. It was like, oh my God, I must
exactly,
be the weirdest 49-year-old person
no,
on earth that cannot find my match.
You're
my match,
because
I like to go to dive bars,
right,
drink craft beer,
right,
and start a mosh pit to Nirvana.
Oh,
that's me.
Yes, Nirvana. Yes.
You know, I'm a weirdo.
It. No, you're not.
But you, my dear, I wish you the most success. Like I said, I want to hug. You're
thank
awesome
you,
and fabulous, and I'm glad you came in to see me today.
Me too.
Thank you, honey.
Thank you for having me.
Let me get back on the mic. Ari Lennox, everybody. Check
yes,
her out. It's
yes,
it's the, that's my niece.
Yes.
Okay.
My auntie. Thank you.
It's Kiss 104.1 Atlanta's R&B.